piging sariwain, pagliligtas niya sa atin. Kaya nating alalahanin, panahong tayo'y inalipin, nang ngalan niya'y ating sambitin. Paano di tayo lingapin? Bayan muling magtipon, awitan ng Panginoon. Sa piging sariwain, pagliligtas niya sa atin. Sa piging sariwain, pagliligtas niya sa atin.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, we celebrate today the life and the holiness of San Roque, a holy man, a healer. For us to be less unworthy to celebrate the mysteries of Christ's love, let us implore the forgiveness by which we are all redeemed and saved. You raise the dead to life in the Spirit, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You bring pardon and peace to the sinner, Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You bring light and hope to those in darkness, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who have taught your church to keep all the heavenly commandments by love of you as God and love of neighbor, grant that practicing the works of charity after the example of Blessed San Roque, we may be worthy to be numbered among the blessed in your kingdom. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. The word of the Lord came to me, Son of man, make known to Jerusalem her abominations. Thus says the Lord God to Jerusalem, by origin and birth you are of the land of Canaan. Your father was an Amorite and your mother a Hittite. As for your birth, the day you were born, your navel cord was not cut. You were neither washed with the water, nor anointed, nor were you rubbed with salt, nor swathed in swaddling clothes. No one looked on you with pity or compassion to do any of these things for you. Rather, you were thrown out on the ground as something loathsome the day you were born. Then I passed by and saw your weltering in your blood. I said to you, live in your blood and grow like a plant in the field. You grew and developed. You came to the age of puberty. Your breasts were formed. Your hair had grown, but you were still stark naked. Again I passed by you and saw that you were now old enough for love. So I spread the corner of my cloth over you to cover your nakedness. I swore an oath to you and entered into a covenant with you. You became mine, says the Lord God. Then I bathed you with water, washed away your blood, and anointed you with oil. I clothed you with an embroidered gown, put sandals of fine leather on your feet. I gave you fine linen, sash and silk, robes to wear. I adorned you with jewelry. I put bracelets on your arms, a necklace about your neck, a ring in your nose, pendants in your ears, and a glorious diadem upon your head. Thus you were adorned with gold and silver. Your garments were of fine linen, silk, and embroidered cloth. Fine flour, honey, and oil were your food. You were exceedingly beautiful, with the dignity of a queen. You were renowned among the nations for your beauty, perfect as it was, because of my splendor which I had bestowed on you, says the Lord God. But you were captivated by your own beauty. You used your renown to make yourself a harlot, and you lavished your harlotry on every passerby whose own you became. Yet I will remember the covenant I made with you when you were a girl, and I will set up an everlasting covenant with you, and you may remember and be covered with confusion, and that you may be utterly silenced for shame. When I pardon you for all you have done, says the Lord God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
You have turned from your anger.
You have turned from your anger.
God indeed is my Savior. I am confident and unafraid. My strength and my courage is the Lord, and He has been my Savior. With joy you will draw water at the fountain of salvation.
You have turned from your anger.
Give thanks to the Lord, acclaim His name. Among the nations, make known His deeds. Proclaim how exalted is His name.
You have turned from your anger.
Sing praise to the Lord for the glorious achievement. Let this be known throughout all the earth. Shout with exultation, O city of Zion, for great in your midst is the Holy One of Israel.
You have turned from your anger. Please all stand.
Alleluia, alleluia. Your teaching is light to my eyes. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Some Pharisees approached Jesus and tested him, saying, "Is it lawful for a man to divorce his wife for any cause whatever. He said in reply, Have you not read that from the beginning, the Creator made them male and female and said, For this reason a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. So they are no longer two, but one flesh. Therefore, what God has joined together, man must not separate. They said to him, Then why did Moses command that the man give the woman a bill of divorce and dismiss her? He said to them, Because of the hardness of your hearts, Moses allowed you to divorce your wives, but from the beginning it was not so. I say to you, whoever divorces his wife, unless the marriage is unlawful, and marries another, commits adultery. His disciples said to him, If that is the case of a man with his wife, it is better not to marry. He answered, Not all can accept this word, but only those to whom that is granted. Some are incapable of marriage because they were born so, some because they were made so by others, some because they have renounced marriage for the sake of the kingdom of heaven. Whoever can accept this ought to accept it. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
I'd like to invite all of you at least after the Mass, when at least we were able to hear a beautiful way of proclaiming the first reading today. I'd like to at least after the Mass to slowly go back to our first reading this Mass from the book of the prophet Ezekiel, chapter 13, verses 1 to 5, 1 to 15, 60 and 63. But we've heard a very powerful introductory words from the prophecy. The Lord told Ezekiel, Speak to the people of Jerusalem about their abominations. And yes, we've heard their faults, their abominations. Nagpakarangya sila, nagpabaya sila, nagpaakit sila sa mga tao, inakit nila ang mga tao. Madaming mga pwede nating masabi nating mga masasama, and so on for other reasons. But you know, more than expressing their faults, there is one beautiful thing that the Lord expressed. At gusto ko pong isummarize yung sinabi sa ating unang pagbasa sa mga salitang ito. I have seen you deformed. I have seen you lifeless. But I am here to make you beautiful and well. But after being beautiful, you wanted to be ugly again. But nonetheless, I am here to make you well. I will remember always what is in my heart, that I am your God, and it is my wish to make you beautiful no matter what. Pero sa araw din pong ito, narinig po natin ang tanong ng mga alagad patungkol sa diborsyo kay Jesus, sa pagtitipan ng lalaki at ng babae, at sa madaming boses patungkol sa katotohanan at sa isyong ito ng ating lipunan ngayon, magandang balikan po natin paano umiibig ang isang tao. Hindi lang po tumitingin, kundi paano umiibig. Our first reading reminded us us how the Lord not only looked but how He loved His people, Jerusalem. And I do believe Jesus brought this from the beginning and until now. Dahil ano po ba ang pag-ibig ng Diyos? Ang pag-ibig ng Diyos, nakita ang tao, nakita ang mundo na sira, nawasak, pero gagawa ng paraan para pagandahin at ayusin tayo muli. Pero alam ng Diyos at alam natin sa ating sarili na marahil mamaya babalik tayo sa kapangitan natin. Mamaya makasalanan ulit tayo. Mamaya gagawin ulit natin yung mga paborito nating mga kasalanan. Pero ang tunay na umiibig, ito lang ang sasabihin. Sige lang. Dahil mahal kita, kahit ba sa dinami ng iyong pagkukulang, aayusin kita. Aayusin natin at pagagandahin natin. Minsan po kasi ganito ang tendency natin. Inayos na kita. Minahal na kita. Ibinigay ko na yung 100%ng pag-iintindi ko sa'yo. Kaya tumino ka na. Sa punto na pumalya ka, maghanap ka na ng iba. Maghanap ka ng ibang magmamahal, makikinig at magtitiwala sa iyo. Maririnig pa nating wala nang tayo. But my dear brothers and sisters, that is not the love of God. Much more, that is not the love that we wish to share to one another, not only to spouses, but to each and every one of us. Hindi lang nagmamahal sa panahon ng kagandahan, mas minamahal at iniintindi sa panahon ng kahinaan at sa panahon ng kabigatan. My dear brothers and sisters, we will encounter our defects. We will encounter the incapacities and the weaknesses of your spouses, of your family members, of friends, of those around you. But we hope and pray that these defects may not push you to love so little, but may help you all the more give the greatest love, the greatest respect, the greatest understanding, the greatest of all that we can do out of love for one another.
Please stand.
Husbands and wives, share in God's creation of new life. Our intercessions today center around the needs of parents and children. For every petition, we shall say, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the church may effectively teach its members the true dignity of marriage and help couples to stay together in their sacred calling. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That government leaders and legislators may enact laws and policies that build families rather than destroy them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That families broken by divorce or separation may find support and understanding from people in their communities. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer. That those experiencing difficulties in their marriage may receive the grace to persevere in their commitments. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That deceased relatives and friends may have the joy and peace in God's eternal home. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray in silence for our own intentions as we continue to lift up all of the intentions offered in this Mass and our prayers for one another. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God of love, you created us male and female to continue your work of creation. May our love for one another reflect your indwelling presence. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated. Please stand.
Pray, dearly beloved, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Receive, O Lord, the offerings of your people, and grant that we who celebrate your Son's work of boundless charity may, by the example of Blessed Roque, be confirmed in love of you and of our neighbor, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For in the marvelous confession of your saints, you make your church fruitful with strength ever new, and offer us sure signs of your love. And that your saving mysteries may be fulfilled, their great example lends us courage. Their fervent prayers sustain us in all we do. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks, as in exaltation we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, and Jose our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, with San Roque and all of the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
With longing for the coming of God's kingdom, let us offer the prayer Christ himself taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Tinapay ng buhay, binasbasan, inatid, inialay. Buhay na ganap ang sa aming kaloob at pagsasalong walang hanggang. Pag-aalay mo, buhay na laan ng lubos sa mundong sa pag-ibig ay kapos. Ikaw, Jesus, ang tinapay ng buhay, binasbasan, inatid, inialay. Buhay na ganap ang sa aming kaloob at pagsasalong walang
Please stand.
Let us pray. Having fed upon the delights of the sacrament of salvation, O Lord, we humbly implore your faithful love, that imitating by your grace the charity of Blessed Roque, we may also be made partakers with him in glory. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
May I solicit your prayers for tomorrow, since our cathedral, the Manila Cathedral, will be welcoming and hosting the altar servers of the parishes and the communities of the Archdiocese of Manila. A part of my appointment as Vice Rector, I am also the minister of these young men here in the Archdiocese, and I think it will be the first time for us to gather as altar servers of the Archdiocese. Although they will come here in representations of 5 or 10, and we will be hoping for a full-packed cathedral tomorrow if the whole parishes or kung sa karamihan po ng parokya will be sending their delegations. Please do accompany us with your prayers, and may these young men grow more in their faith and their love of God as they continue their service. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our celebration has been offered. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Maria, ina ng awa.